उत्पादते पुंसा शोक मोह भय वह हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण
सो वी विल जस्ट हैव अ शॉर्ट डिस्कशन फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवत गीता टेक्स्ट नंबर 28
चैप्टर
सेवेंथ चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 28 केशां त्वंतगतं पापं
केशां त्वंतगतं पापं
केशं त्वंतगतं पापं
केशां त्वंतगतं पापं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणं
जनानां पुण्यकर्मणं
द्वंद्वमोहनिर्मुक्ता भजन्ते मम दृढ़ा व्रता एषं त्वंतगतं पापं जनानां पुण्यकर्मणं ते द्वंद्वमोहनिर्मुक्ता भजन्ते मम दृढ़ा व्रता एषां अंतगतम कंप्लीटली इरैगेटेड पापम सिन जनानम ऑफ द पर्सन पुण्य पायस कर्मणम
कर्मणम
प्रीवियस एक्टिविटीज
दे
द्वंद्व of
duality.
Moha,
delusion.
Nirmukta, free from.
Bhajante,
engaged in devotional service.
Mam,
to me,
Dridhavrata with determination.
With determination.
Persons who have acted piously in previous life and in this life, and whose sinful activities are completely eradicated, are freed from dualities of delusion, and they engage themselves in my service with determination. Purport? Those eligible for elevation to transcendental position are mentioned in this verse. For those who are sinful, atheistic, foolish, and deceitful, it is very difficult to transcend the dualities of desire and hate. Only those who have passed their lives in practicing the regulative principle of religion, who have acted piously and who have conquered sinful reactions, can accept devotional service and gradually rise to the pure knowledge of Supreme Personality of God. Then gradually they can meditate in trance on Supreme Personality of God. That is the process of being situated on the spiritual platform. This elevation is possible in Krishna consciousness in the association of pure devotees. For in the association of great devotees, one can be delivered from delusion. It is stated in Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 5, Chapter 5, Text Number 2, that if one actually wants to be liberated, he must render service to the devotees. Mahat sevam dwara ahor dumukta. But one who associates with materialistic people is on the path of leading to darkest region of existence. Tamo dharam yo sutasangi sangam. All the devotees of the Lord traverse this earth just to recover the conditioned soul from their delusion. The impersonalists who do not know that forgetting their constitutional position as subordinate to Supreme Lord is the greatest violation of God's law. Unless one is reinstated in his own constitutional position, it is not possible to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead or to fully engage in his transcendental loving service with determination. So, the Lord has said a lot here. This is the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. In the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, first of all, Krishna talks of how rare you would appreciate something, understanding how rare is the object itself. First of all, starting 7th chapter, Krishna explains the rareness of the position that we are on. So therefore he goes, Manushyanam sahasesu kasyajata pisidaye yatata amapisidanam kasyambhan vedipata. In same in Bhagavatam it says, Brahmanam sahasrebya satrayaji visishate satrayaji sahasrebya sarvavedanta paraka sarvavedanta vipkutra vishnu bhakta visishate vaishnavanam sahasrebya etanthiteko visishate. It is says, Brahmanam sahasrebya. Now, of all the species that are there, what is the percentage of Brahman species? Meaning, ya brahma vyati sa brahmanaha. What is the percentage of the people who try to understand Brahman? You know what is the percentage?
2%.
Less than
0.2%.
Point two percent.
Of entire creation. And they are also included as the people who are impersonalists, Brahmavyati, those who are Paramatmavadis, Brahmavyatis, and those who are Bhagavanvyatis. Only 0.2% of the people are even interested in making a question of Atma Jigyasa, of questioning of Hum Kaun Hai, Wo Kaun Hai.
और वो रास्ता क्या है जो उनके साथ जुड़ जाता है. हु एम आई, हु इज ही, एंड व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस दैट कनेक्ट्स टू ही एंड मी. ओनली 0.2%. सो देयर फोर कृष्ण सेज मनुष्यानुसार्षेषु कश्चिद्य गतिशील. ऑफ मिलियंस ऑफ सहस्रस मिलियंस ऑफ ह्यूमंस कश्चित कश्चित संभव हो सकता है. कृष्ण इज नॉट गारंटिंग दैट दैट वेरी फ्यू विल बिकम, बट इज ऑल्सो नॉट डिनाइंग अ फैक्ट दैट वेरी फ्यू कैन. नाउ वी माइट थिंक कृष्ण इज मेकिंग अ चांस ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग हिम ऑलमोस्ट नील, इजंट इट? सो देयरफॉर व्हाई डू आई स्ट्रगल? डू यू फील दैट? इफ चांस इज सो नील, व्हाई शुड आई स्ट्रगल? समटाइम्स पीपल फील दैट कि भागवत गीता सेज दैट इट इज सो हार्ड ऑफ मिलियंस एंड बिलियंस ऑफ पीपल, हार्डली वन नोज मी टू. सो देयरफॉर व्हाट इज अ गारंटी दैट आई वेस्ट माई टाइम ऑन इट? You know what example Prabhupada is to give? When there is a cinema going on, when there is a big, you know, film going on. So the movie is on. How many people are inside? Maybe some of the halls are so big, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 10,000. Are there halls that big? I have not been to movie theater, so. So it's big. What if somebody announces in a mic that the theater is in the fire, the theater is burning, and within 2 hours everything will be devoured? What do we think? You know what, because I am at the back seat and the entrance is at front, I might not be the one to get out, so let me just get burnt and die here. Is that the logic we follow? Or do I try to be the 10 that are able to come out? We try to be the 10. So therefore, that's what the existence is. If there is a fire, you don't want to be the one that is to be burning. You want to be the one that is to be exiting, out of the door. So therefore, when Krishna is not denying a fact of a perfection, he says, yes, possible, but very few. But one who tries, then he says, the person who decides to be the one to be out of it, he says, Manushyanam sarsasu kathijata tishidaya yatata mapishiddhanam kashinvan betitatvataha kashinvan. So many people are having a problem, and everyone that is having a problem looks for a solution. Yes? Anyone that realizes that there is a problem looks for a solution. Now everyone that is look for a solution finds a solution. So therefore, Manushyanam sarsasu, every Manushya is struggling. That Krishna is saying. What are they struggling for? Existence. The problem is this. Everyone is starving to the last stage of hunger. Hunger for sense gratification. So therefore, but the problem is, there is only one. Just imagine, 500 devotees all starving and only one plate of prasada. So what is everyone going to struggle for? To be the part of that plate. The fact is everyone is hungry. So therefore, Krishna is saying that Manushyanam Sahasreshu, there are millions of people who are trying to achieve something in life. Okay? There are millions of people who are trying to achieve something in life. So some people struggle, but they get to the wrong kitchen. Instead of being in the right area, like you know how Prabhuji said that going to Vrindavan was such a troublesome, but part of it was the part of that Tangawala who took such a decision to go to the place. There was no road, because he had a hope that this is the way I make my money. I'm sure if he knew that I'm going to be stuck in somewhere in the hole and I'll be stuck there forever, he would have not tried also. But the thing is hope. The hope is that I'm going to get money off this man. And when everyone is stuck, he finds the way and goes there, ultimately becomes successful. Although the path of success is always, as Krishna says, yatra dhagre vishamiva parinami vittopama. The actual path of success has to be hard. If it is too easy, then that's not the right path. So the point here is many people struggle, but people get to the wrong kitchen to satisfy the hunger. So therefore, manushyanam sahasreshu kashchidyatatishidaya. Millions of people,
very few attain success. Then what he says? Millions of people, few people attain success. Kasiddha tatisiddhaye yatatam api siddhana. Then he goes, then it takes, he says, millions of the people who have succeeded to some level now. First is millions of people who try, of that few succeed, and millions of the people who are succeeding. Then goes, kashin, kashin, one, vetitatataha. Only very few understand me in a fact. So first part, the example is given, is something like it is a gigantic ocean. The entire creation is like a gigantic ocean. Now if you are flying over the ocean with a flight, but you drop a needle into the water, and the challenge is that you come out of the flight, get to the ocean and find the needle you dropped. How easy is it? Easy, Prabhu? So the point is, millions of species of life. So what is the species of life calculated?
8,400,000
species of life. And of that, what are humans? Human meaning something that looks in two legs.
400,000.
So 400,000 are not a devotee species here. It's something that looks like a human. It might be no man's in somewhere in the dense forest. Now, according to the scripture, when we give an example of a needle, is a human form of life. Of that entire species that you travel with, the one sensible life that gives you a sense of Atma Jigyasa is compared to a needle in the entire ocean. So, within this ocean of repeated birth and death, Sansara Dhavana Lida Loka, Pranaya Karunya Ganaganaptam, this material existence is compared to
forest fire.
The forest fire and also ocean. Also compared to the ocean. And human form of life is one needle within that ocean. Now you have it. We have in the hand. Okay? What do? You throw that needle from your own hand into the middle of the ocean. Now you have to go search for it. So to find that valuable species of life again, that can give us some sense of what is God. You have to go through the entire cycle within that ocean and look for that species again. So therefore Krishna goes, casts in one, many, only very few find that species. The lucky ones. Then now here he goes, now tesam tvantagatam papam, of those lucky ones. Now we know the level of the lucky part, the lucky jackpot. Of those who have found that needle compared a human form of life. He goes, tesam tvantagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam. Those people who have completely finished their sins. Antapapam janmanam. Now sins are not one lifetime. It can be janmanam. But sometimes people say, why do good things happen to bad people and bad things happen to good people? It's something like this. If you move to this house, how long have you been here, Prabhuji?
4 years.
So how is your neighbor? Nice? Both sides never good? Now, just an example. If a cop come and arrest one of the nice neighbors that you think from your understanding, come and arrest them and take them somewhere else, then your understanding, oh, that guy was very nice. I know him for 5 years. He's very nice. So you analyze from the point of how long you know him for. But then the cop says, no, 20 years ago he killed somebody in Florida. But that part we don't know. So ultimately when we make a understanding of somebody of who is bad and good, we say, अरे बहुत अच्छा था, एक बार तो dinner में भी बुलाया था, परंतु आपको पता नहीं 20 साल पहले dinner में किसी को beak मिला करके मार भी डाला था. There is no chance, we don't know on that. So we take this immediate nature of somebody being good. But Krishna is saying, नहीं, जन्मनम. Then he goes, तेसम त्वंत गतम पापम.
बहुत जन्म का पाप को जिसने धो डाला हो, खत्म किया हो, देन पुण्य कर्मणम, तरीगोस पुण्य कर्मणम, हाउ हैज ही बर्न्ड, ही सेंग पुण्य कर्मणम. नाउ डिवोशन टू कृष्ण इज नॉट डिपेंडिंग इन एनी पुण्य कर्मणम, बट डिवोशन टू कृष्ण कैन बी गेन्ड बाय द हेल्प ऑफ पुण्य कर्मणम. Why do you have Varnashram Dharma? To attain pure love of God? What is the purpose of Varnashram Dharma? To make you eligible. To be pure enough to engage in devotional service. Purpose of Varnashram Dharma is not like what does the scripture say? If you follow a perfect way of Varnashram Dharma for 100 lifetimes, what's the result of such? You know? If you follow, if you do 100 Ashwamedha Yajna, you become Indra. And if you follow the Varnashram Dharma for 100 births, perfectly, if you are born as a Kshatriya, you follow the Dharma of Kshatriya perfectly. If you are born into Brahman family, you follow the Dharma of Brahman family perfectly for 100 years. You know what is the result of such? You take the position of Brahma. It is not saying that you get pure love of God. You get a position. But the thing is, to have a position of Brahma is a selfless position. To become selfless, you need to follow the Varnashram Dharma perfectly. Yes? And what is the definition of bhakti? Para dukha dukhi. You know, process of bhakti, bhakti means para dukha dukhi, means being distressed by the distress of somebody else. And such example is in the case of Maharaj Chitraketu. Why did he get the son called Harshasoka? Why was that? The destiny says that he is not supposed to have a child. How did he get it? Because Angira and Naradmuni became distressed by looking the distress of him. So therefore says, although your piety cannot allow you to have a child, but we can use our piety to give you a child. So that is the nature. The first nature of somebody who is to become Krishna conscious is to become distressed by the distress of others. So now in position of Brahma basically means you sacrifice everything for somebody else. That's Varnashram Dharma about. But it doesn't allow you to get bhakti. So therefore, जन्मना पुण्य कर्मणा, अगर आपने हजारों जन्म तक अपना माता पिता का सेवा बढ़िया से किया हो, इफ यू हैव गिवन द चैरिटी टू द ब्राह्मणास फॉर मिलियंस ऑफ लाइफ टाइम्स, इफ यू हैव परफेक्टेड देव द्विज गुरु प्राज्ञ पूजनम शौच मार्जवान, यू हैव रिस्पेक्टेड ऑल द डेमिगॉड्स, यू हैव रिस्पेक्टेड योर ऑन पेरेंट्स, यू हैव रिस्पेक्टेड योर ऑन गुरु इवन इन द मटीरियल लेवल, you have always looked after the elderly, you have always loved the children, which is part of dharma, then this allows you. The shastra says that piety can bring you in contact with devotees. The piety can allow such to happen. And because you do such a pious work, you are doing a distribution to the poor people, that can allow you to come in contact with the devotee. Now where does the bhakti come from? Janana Punya Karmanam. Then it is said, Tedwanda Mohinar Bhukta, in purport, Prabhupada says, the key of advancement to Krishna consciousness is Mahatsevam Dwara Ahor Bhimukta Tamodaram Yosuta Sangi Sangha. He says that to get this bhakti, to fight the dwanda, what are the two dwandas Krishna talks about? Icha Dveshe Samudhena Dwande Mohina Bharata. Sarvabhutani sammoham sargayanti parantapa. Oh, parantapa? And parantapa means what? Why is Arjun known as parantapa? The subduer of enemy. Jo satru ka ant kar sakta hai, that's Arjun. So he is telling Arjun, I can give you 100% credit for subduing the enemy. Yes, you have that ability. But you need to fight one more battle for me. Fighting the battle with enemy, no problem, you can fight. But what is one more battle Krishna wants Arjuna to fight? He said, I want you to fight the battle of Dwande Moihna Bharata. Again, fighting a battle with sense gratification of Ichcha and Dvesha, desire and hate. The life is based on that. What is the life of? As we take birth in this world, we do one thing. First, before we start creating things, we create a people around us. Isn't it? It's like if you give a toy to a child, what does he do? He tries to find the people to play around with. So he tries to find the circle first. So when we take birth in this material world, first we try to build a circle. So within this circle we go, okay, this guy is my friend and this guy is my enemy. This guy is my friend, this guy is my enemy, I like him, I don't like him. So before even anything happens in life, what we do? We create a group. So therefore Krishna is saying, Ichcha Dvesha Samuthena, this principle of Ichcha and Dvesha takes place first in life. And this is very common. If you want to feed a children, if they are hungry and say, what you want to eat? They don't say, give me anything. Do they say that? If the children are hungry, and you say, what do you want me to give you? They never say, give what you want. They will always have the choice of what they want. So this is called Ichcha and Dvesha. So Krishna is saying the entire creation, sarga yanti parantava, the sarga is, means creation, visarga means annihilation. So sarga yanti parantava, O parantava, subduer of enemy, I know you can subdue the enemy very well, but I suggest you to subdue another enemy called the Ichcha and Dvesha. So Ichcha Dvesha, so Krishna is talking about te dwanda, those people who take shelter of a guru or a pure devotee. If you have done pious life in many lives before this, then that can allow you to have an association of a devotee. Then within that association of the devotee, what you do? Dwande Mohena Varta, start fighting a battle of desire and hate. And Krishna is also just suggesting Arjuna the same thing. He said, I want you to fight a battle now. And this time the battle is not with Duryodhana, but it is the problem that is arising from your own mind, which is called the battle of desire and hate. That if that happens, te dunda mayanar mukta, for those devotees who are free from this battle or who have won this battle, then Krishna says what? Those people who have won the battle, bandur atmatmatana tasya yanatmai mamanajitaha anatmana satasatve bhartate maiva sattuva. Those people who have won the battle, then you make friend with the mind becomes the best friend. Right after you win the battle. Because you tell mind what to do, mind does not tell you what to do after that. Then if that happens, what's the third step? The first is to do a punya karma. Yes, always follow the Varnashram Dharma properly. The second step is what? Come into the association of a bona fide spiritual master. Then under the help of a bona fide spiritual master, you fight a battle of Ichcha and Dvesha. Then as a result of that battle, Krishna says, Bhajante mam dridavrata. Tab thoda bhajan hoga, Hare Krishna naam tab ho sakti hai. Anyone can do the mopping or sweeping, which is punya karmana. Unless it is a mopping and sweeping, the direct temple of the Supreme Lord. That's another part. But doing a hall cleaning for the food for life, that's another.